Today, I'm going to show you the bone building exercises specifically for the hips and the exercises specifically for the spine. This is a question I often hear from men who usually want to focus on one area over the other. Whichever you prefer, I've got you covered, so let's get started. First things first, why should we focus on the hips and the spine separately? Well, the bones in those areas are different in structure and function, which means the exercises to strengthen them need to be different too. For the hips, we want to focus on exercises that involve weight bearing and impact. For the spine, we need to look at both weight bearing and core stability exercises that strengthen the muscles supporting the spine. The point is to highly target the area we want to strengthen. This is something we discussed in my interview with Professor Belinda Beck.
That's the really cool thing about exercise. It's not a shotgun approach. You don't just do some exercise and your whole skeleton adapts. It is highly targeted. Only the loaded bones adapt, and they adapt in a way that is most likely to improve the strength of the bone.
So we want to put strain across the area we want to strengthen. With this in mind, let's first clear the air about the exercises that won't help. The main ones that don't help with osteoporosis are walking and running. They don't put enough load on the bones. They're good to do for your general health, but not for strengthening bone. Here's what will help, and let's talk hips first. These exercises are going to target your hip joints, which are crucial for movement and balance. The first one is bounding. Bounding puts more load on the hips than running or walking. It's a great start and is recommended in combination with other exercises. Next up, squats and leg press. These exercises are awesome for building strength in your hips. They work by loading the hip joints and engaging the surrounding muscles. High impact exercises like jumping rope or box jumps really amp up the load on your hip bones, making them stronger over time. And don't forget lunges. They're fantastic for weight transfer and balance, both of which are key to hip health. Now we have exercises for the lumbar spine. But before we get into that, if we haven't met yet, my name's Dr. Tom Forfa. I'm a medical doctor from Australia, and I reversed my own osteoporosis naturally using methods such as the ones I'm sharing with you today. And unlike 99% of other osteoporosis YouTubers, I focus on one thing, naturally reversing men's osteoporosis. And by doing that, I can help men with osteoporosis better than anyone else. So if you'd like more resources and support for men with osteoporosis or help stopping your bone loss, see the links in the description below. Now let's focus on your spine. For these exercises, we're targeting both the vertebrae and the muscles that support your back. Deadlifts are a powerhouse move. They put strain across your lumbar spine and engage the spinal erectors, which are the muscles running along your spine. This is my favorite exercise for strengthening the lumbar spine. It's one of the things I did to get my lumbar T scores from -3 to almost normal levels. Back extensions are another great way to engage the spine directly. They help build muscle along the spine, which in turn supports bone health. Planks are your go-to for core stability, as well as other core exercises like dead bugs, one of my favorites as well. A strong core means better support for your spine, which is essential for preventing injuries and maintaining bone density. And here's a fun one, walking with a weighted backpack. It adds extra load to your spine, encouraging bone growth and stability. I've personally never done it, but I've heard wonderful things about it, and I intend to get a weighted vest or backpack to start doing it. Now, no exercise routine is complete without understanding some key principles that make these exercises effective. So here are a few for you. Number one, progressive overload. Gradually increase the weight or intensity of your exercises. This is crucial for stimulating bone growth. Number two, impact loading. Exercises that involve impact or sudden force, like jumping or dropping, are particularly beneficial for bone density, especially in the hips. Number three, specificity. Like we mentioned earlier, focus on exercises that specifically target the area you want to strengthen. For hips, focus on your lower body exercises. For the spine, focus on core and back exercises. And finally, frequency. Consistency is everything here. Studies show that as little as 2 workouts per week, if done correctly, can lead to improvements in BMD. But I would aim to do it, these exercises, you know, at least 3 or 4 times a week to really see some results. So there you have it. The best exercises to build bone density in your hip and your spine, along with the principles to make them effective. If you found this video useful, be sure to give us a thumbs up, subscribe for more content like this, and hit that notification bell so you never miss an update. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.